I'm Sir Tap Top, and welcome to Let's Play Transistor. Just in case you're hearing this while the Black Friday flash sale is still going on PS4, this game was $8, and you'd be completely insane not to pick it up right now.
Hey, Red. We're not gonna get away with this, are we?
Like, I can't believe I didn't get this sooner. It's made by Supergiant Games.
Together again. Sort of.
They're the people who did Bastion. You might notice it has a lot of similar aesthetics. Got the same narrator talking through you through the game sort of thing. I actually like it a ton more than Bastion. It's... man, just... the background art is just absolutely beautiful. I really wish more games would do stuff like this. And it doesn't... like, there's this sense that pre-rendered and 2D backgrounds are cheap, but just... this looks absolutely beautiful, and...
they want you really...
could not do this sort of thing in 3D. So these are our enemies, the process.
One more alley, east of the bay. Think I know where we are.
I've already beaten the game, but I won't be spoiling anything for you. I won't be playing the full game, probably.
What are these creeps? Look, don't fret, just...
these are turns. These basically turn this into a sort of... like, you know, well, a turn-based thing. Lets you plan out your moves. Sort of like a suddenly a tactical RPG. But you can also use your moves in, you know, real time, just as you saw.
One another.
And while your turn is recharging, you can't use most of your abilities, most anything that's offensive. But there are also some abilities that let you do stuff between turns. There's actually a ton of abilities that make some really interesting combinations. This is, of course, a new game, not, you know, my new game plus two that I'm...
hey, up there.
Been playing.
Hello, world.
So beautiful.
Look at all that. We're on the edge of town, 100 blocks away.
I also like that... you know, I said it doesn't look cheap because they do a lot of stuff to make the backgrounds, like there's parallax layers, there's, you know, these particle effects. It's a lot more than just, you know, a little 3D model walking around on a 2D set. It just looks really, really good.
There's the empty set. Still too close to it. We better get as far from there as possible.
I've taken many, many, many screenshots of this game. Also, there's tons of little programming references in this game. It doesn't really matter if it goes over your head, but it's a really cool bonus if you do understand. Oh, can't go that way. Yeah, when you're in a battle, there's these sort of invisible walls to keep you in the battle area. And the combat system is just brilliant. That's the main reason I got interested in this over Bastion, because Bastion's fairly, just felt fairly standard, but this just has some really cool stuff.
You okay? I see. Sure. She wants to come along. We can use her. She says hello.
And all these abilities we get can be sort of combined in different ways. So like this one will let you split up your attack, like Crash will have three prongs instead of one. And the combat system is just really brilliant. I really hope they do a sequel or something else with this combat system. And through these terminals you get lots of background through the game, you know, lore and stuff.
3 days this time.
And I love the sword's reactions.
Maybe next year.
And through comments on these boards, you get to see sort of Red's reaction to a lot of what's going on. And I love the little circuit patterns the transistor makes when you're walking through. Just lots of, there's so many little touches in this game that look just really cool.
End of the plaza. It's you.
And the little details, you know, near things interacted, like days posted, there's a whole lot of those. And some are pretty funny or interesting.
I'm so sorry, Red. They took your voice. I couldn't stop them. But we took something of theirs. Hey, let's just go. Come on, just go. Just...
So we were a singer, and someone took our voice. Oh, hello.
Young lady here to see you.
And I like, if you notice, everything starts off being called just process, and
she
then
tried to trick us.
As the transistor like makes up a nickname, that's the name you see.
Finally.
So we called this one Young Lady. And that's what you know it as through the rest of the game.
Through there. I think I know a place we could get a ride.
The commentary is actually kind of annoying for a Let's Play, which is partially why I won't be doing, you know, the full game, but it really adds a lot to the game when you're playing. Also, one more thing. When the transistor talks, you might have noticed it glows a little bit. On PlayStation 4, you can actually set it so the voice comes out of the controller and the controller, since it has the light bar, it actually flashes in time with the sword and just is really immersive and feel like it's like you're holding the transistor, sort of. It just, it sounds sort of silly, but it really works well.
This didn't used to be here.
This might trick you into thinking there will be puzzles in the game. There basically aren't. It's really just combat and story.
Okay.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Mr. Moyle. It's him, all right, but I can barely hear him. Interesting.
This is the sort of thing that lets you dash through enemies.
Oh no.
There's the process.
Cut off our escape.
I really love the way the enemies look.
Come on, man, tough guy.
The main benefit of Jaunt is that it's generally faster than moving, or it's cheaper than moving in turns, so it can let you do some pretty cool stuff. It also lets you escape jerks like this. But yeah, you can aim your attacks very carefully in this mode. So we're gonna slice through these guys. There you go.
Back where they belong.
Level up.
Hey.
This is an RPG, so yeah, you get to pick functions when you level up. Mask is actually very important. It's one of my favorites.
Still here. Okay, you're in.
So yeah, this is where you can choose your abilities. It's not gonna let us change it, but you can add abilities to like sub, what is it called? Like it adds it as an upgrade to these abilities. Like, let's do that one. The backstab damage isn't a very useful upgrade.
Just one more block. I want to show you something. Okay, there's a. Wait. Back.
Hello. Designation jerk. When you activate a turn against an upgraded form of an enemy, it'll give you a little bit of info about what the upgrade adds. And what's really cool about the New Game Plus mode is that it basically starts you off with more upgraded versions of the enemies. Jaunt's main usefulness outside of a turn, you know, quick movements and turns, is that you can activate it even when your turn is up. So you can use it to quickly get away.
Now,
let's just take care of these creeps. Also, you have to pick up these cells whenever you kill an enemy, or else they'll respawn after a few seconds. Let's take care of that guy. Also, you can overload your turn. Like, if there's any amount of turn left, you can add one more ability no matter how much it costs. And this really makes it a lot easier to plan your turns out, because you don't have to, like, fiddle with what you're going to do with the last, you know, 2% of your turn. It just, if you overload your turn, it's just going to take a little longer to get your next turn. It's actually a really well thought out system. I just can't stress how much I love the combat system in this.
So is this whole block.
Which is why I've replayed the full game twice in the last 3 days. Just absolutely love this game. That's why I'm let's playing it out of nowhere. Alright, finally. Alright, we're gonna put stealth in. We're gonna put jaunt. Oh yeah, jaunt lets some actions with a wind-up activate instantly. They still have, you know, recovery. But that can change the utility of some abilities by quite a lot.
Yeah, good call. That's our way out.
Such a pretty game. Just ridiculous. Okay. It's also on PC.
64 on ramp. 5 blocks down. Take the second right. Do not turn left.
PC and PS4.
Thanks for the lift.
Mr. Left.
Hi. Turn left. Thought we were gonna skip town. We're going back there. You met these things. They do not have a sense of humor.
I love these story sections.
Wipe you out and take whatever's left of me back to those two-bit Camerata pieces of trash. Look, whatever you're thinking, do me a favor. Let me go.
The game's great on either platform. I personally prefer it on PS4 because of the controller thing.
Poor bike. Just 10 more blocks to the set.
It's really hard to express how cool it is. Like, it sounds kind of silly, but it really works well. But other than that, you know, it's perfectly fine to play on PC or PS4.
Stronger than the last ones.
It's easy to forget, but if you...
You still hear me?
Try to remember to take a turn in a battle against any new things. Like, depending on your playstyle, you might not always use turns in some of these easier battles, but it's a good idea to get informed on what these enemies do, though sometimes it's pretty obvious, like in this case.
They were waiting. Thought we'd make good time, too.
He's gonna pulse. Some of these pillar things pulse in time with the music, and it's a really cool effect. Might happen later on.
Not a soul. Hardly recognize this place without the foot traffic.
And you can check out sort of the lore in lots of areas by, you know,
terminal still up.
Terminals and other things you can examine.
Must be starving. Sea monsters really the only choice here. Yes. Just have to get back to your place before it gets cold.
You do have actual choices. They don't make a huge difference, but it changes what the narrator basically responds with. It's pretty fun to see him, you know, either agree or be kind of like, oh, that's not really what I expected.
Left ourselves open for a seafood flatbread.
So if you don't pick the sea monster, he's kind of like, oh, yeah, that's okay.
Fertile ground.
There's this jump ability that I have no idea why it exists. Also, this game...
Never seen Gold Walk cleared out.
This remote plays quite well. Though there's one oddity when you're remote playing this game. I don't have anything to change. When you remote play, if you start the game with the DualShock 4, it has, you know, R2 is what does turns. If you start it with the PS Vita, it, you know, swaps L2, R2, and, you know, L1, R1, which makes it more playable on Vita. It does not do this if you've already started the game, then start remote play. Minor annoyance, but it plays much better with the turn controls on L1 and R1. And these packet things explode when you, you know, hit them with anything.
Guess what's inside? Back for more.
Oh, it's a jerk. All right. One cool thing you can do, mask lets you deal extra damage on your first attack when unmasking. And you can sort of save yourself some turn by activating mask before you start your turn. Oh, right. The weeds actually heal other enemies. Pretty annoying. So we want to wipe those out. Not quite dead. Parker? Kind of in the way, bro. I'm glad that hit because I can't see. There we go.
All quiet.
Level 3!
What do you see?
So we can spawn... These let us spawn those packets we just saw that explode. This lets us, you know, it's a basic charm effect. Actually don't like charm very much in this game because you can't hurt anything you've charmed. So it basically negates the damage of any effect you attach it to, but it can still be useful for like cloaking, and then, you know, it has this area of effect charm that turns everything around you into an ally for a brief period. And these are your save points as well as, you know, change ability things. So let's add it to that, sure. The one thing you have to be careful of, if you want to use backstab from mask, the charm actually gets in the way, so actually I'm gonna not do that, because I actually really like backstab with the mask to do extra damage. Also, when you inspect the functions, you get lore.
You got a shortlist. More than just a name to them now.
And you unlock more lore by using each function in each, you know, method. Like, there's a normal... You can use it as an attack, you can use it as an upgrade, or you can use it as a passive effect, which we don't have unlocked yet. And it also lets you see all of your upgrades when, you know, you put these abilities on it, and there's some really cool combos. No, I don't want to use that. Oh, wait. I guess I could put it in its own slot. I like the idea of the charm effect. It's just, it's really annoying to not be able to hurt things. I like hurting things.
They're saying everyone up and left. Nothing to see here. Admin's just towing the line.
When you can post a comment, it's basically Red's commentary.
Yeah, I'll say.
And I like her backspacing out of some things. Like, it's like, I really want to say this, but they're probably gonna, you know,
out of the channel,
moderate it out.
8 blocks off. Almost there. Pink is in.
I love his commentary for some of the attacks. Oh, and there's little info things at the top left there that just shows you random tips. Also, things continue moving very, very slowly in a turn, so sometimes you can have stuff happen like what just happened there where I actually missed because something was already in pretty fast motion. You can basically, what you want to do to avoid that being an issue is you want to queue up your most important attack first, because the other ones have a slight chance of missing. It really depends on which abilities you have. Enemy abilities with high knockback can screw you up a bit if you try to queue up repeated attacks on an enemy you're knocking back. It's generally not a big deal. I've missed very few attacks due to that.
Get ready to get jumped.
It's just something to be aware of.
Or not. Let's not stick around.
But it's so pretty. Yes, it is.
We could just sit and watch the world go by. Got some kind of cheerleader this time. Now to mop up.
And you can use mask in a turn to, you know, amplify your next attack. But like I said, generally you want to mask before you start the turn, if you can.
Must have heard. I guess we're done here.
The music's really nice and moody. Hopefully, yeah, we should be able to make it to the first boss fight. There aren't many boss fights, but they're all done pretty well.
Here we are. Deserted. Unless you count him.
Get prepped, punk.
Where'd everybody go? Well, we're gonna get you out of here. He says the process wiped him out. He's too far gone. They know we're here.
Hello. Actually, oh right, the young ladies have a bad habit of warping around when you hit them, so it's really hard to queue up multiple attacks on them. I usually just try to remember to only do one at a time. They also spawn these copies. There you go.
Eat that. Look at him go.
It's basically not possible to stop all those bad cells from spawning, but you can try to get most of them before they do. Persistent. Oh, nice trick with these jerks. You can trick them into healing you. Though you have to watch that timer, because once they stop, they'll start hurting you again. As you might expect, when you use items as an upgrade instead of an attack, they may have, you know, reduced effectiveness. If you use Charm as a main attack, it has a much longer duration than it usually does if you, you know, apply it to a different attack.
Let's have a look downstairs. Gotta be a leader somewhere. Pole's a little out of date. Facsimile's finally gonna catch a break.
Let's vote for me. Aw, yeah.
Yeah, if only. Let's get back to it.
Pretty. All right, the opera house. Look at that.
When I first saw you up on that stage back there, it was like everyone loved you. Everyone except for them.
You can hum at any time with L1. doesn't do anything, but at a couple areas, things happen. It's memory time.
When you speak, I hear silence. Every word a defiance. I can hear, oh, I can hear. Think I'll go where it suits me. Moving out to the country.
Terminal's sort of an awkward position, but it's
a what?
Relevant.
A what? A nothing. Hey. Is that you?
I think so.
Oh. Look at you.
Signed off.
You're alive.
One way to put it.
Me, I'm not so sure. Hey, say something already.
About that.
Say something, will you? Oh, no.
This is our first boss fight. Actually, it's Mask first. Don't think it's gonna hit. There you go. Ow. There you go.
She must have felt that.
I love the, like, white...
She's back.
...process goop you knock out of them.
Ow. She's patching up.
Yeah, these stupid weeds heal her, so you want to clear those out. Excuse me. The turns have pretty interesting dynamics with some of the bosses. It can be pretty hard to dodge some of those without taking a turn.
Almost got her.
Boink!
Sybil. Round three.
I love the background soundtrack to this fight. Fits the mood very well. It's unfortunately kind of easy to miss because, you know, you're fighting. I also like Sybil's creepy voice. Excuse me, Sybil. Holy crap. crap.
Okay, it's on.
Very good idea to wait for a opportunity to use a turn with the stealth thing. Sorry, Sybil.
Her trace. Hello again, Sybil. Your camarada friends. I want you to tell us where they are. Do you understand? Sybil's trace.
All right, we'll take a look at the back door thing.
We're going downtown. The process will be waiting for us. With any luck. Hey, hey.
Pretty boat.
You'll be back someday.
I'm sure we will. Jerks.
Sybil was their eyes and ears. Got close to you. To us.
Love the art style so much.
We're hunting people. Don't know for what. But I bet I know who does. I'm gonna ask him why. And I have this feeling he's gonna let us know.
This is about a 6-hour game for one playthrough, I think. It's definitely worth at least one replay through. And you can make it pretty hard by using all the limiters. We haven't unlocked those yet, but limiters basically let you improve the abilities of the process. And so you get a little bit of extra experience, and the process gets...
Okay, road to high rise should be right around.
It gets difficult in a lot of interesting ways, like those cells. Sometimes it'll spawn more, or they'll spawn shielded cells. It makes it difficult in interesting ways.
These are new. Good to go. Taking snapshots.
Drink.
The process still a step ahead, but they haven't stopped us.
So the game gets difficult in interesting ways instead of just, you know, they deal more damage, you deal less damage, and blah blah blah. It's got pretty cool stuff.
Is that? What do we have here? Sounds like waves.
I love this area.
So
look at that sunset.
Don't know what I was expecting. Wasn't this?
This is sort of your chill out area. And you can do little. Do we have any open? Yes, we do. These little practice
tests.
Let's
try door number one.
You get bonus experience and get to have a little fun by doing some specially made tests.
Water.
I love how when you're in turn, the camera follows the bounce ball. Actually, I guess it does anyway. Bounce is a pretty cool ability. I don't use it too much though, because the actual damage it has is pretty weak. But you can add it to other abilities to chain them.
Can't even take us on their own turf. Thought there'd be more of them.
So these are fun little challenges, and it unlocks music that you can listen to anytime in this area. Sort of a fun little way to do a sound, you know, sound select sort of thing.
Now I want to know what's in door number two.
Well, we can't open it, buddy, so cool your jets.
Hello, what's this? That's Sybil. Always palling up to you and everybody. Showed her true colors back there. Wonder how her camarada friends are gonna feel knowing she's leading us straight to them.
So pretty. So yeah, that is Transistor. I highly, highly recommend it. It's for PS3 or PS4 or PC. If you still make the Black Friday discounts, it's a little cheaper on both. Cheaper on PS4 currently. Absolutely amazing game. Way worth even the $20 launch price, let alone, you know, any discount you can get. Just cannot recommend enough.